All the jitters, just get them out. Okay. You are messing up the shot. Thank you.
Bye. Edit. And action.
Okay, what's going on?
Girl,
you sorry. Okay, no more talking again. Sorry.
Okay. This is gonna end up somewhere in the video. Wow.
It is.
Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. I have my special friend and guest here. This is Jen. You guys always hear me talking about her or giving her a shout out or something. But I wanted to start off a new series on the channel called Lock Talk. Ooh. And Jen is going to open up our series this month. And basically, we're going to be talking with different people that are locks, have had locks, and just figure out their story and hear how they're enjoying the journey. So, Jen,
yes,
nice to have you.
Thank you.
Thanks for doing this with me.
Yep. No
I kind of had to prep her, guys, but she's ready.
So I just moved out here to Austin, maybe almost a year now. It's going to be March soon, so yeah, almost close to a year. That flew by really fast, but I'm loving it here. I'm excited about my future, and I mean, that's basically it right now.
All right, so we're going to get into the lock questions. Jen, do you remember the specific moment when you decided that you were going to get your hair locked?
So I do have a specific moment, but like before that, I kind of had an idea as to like when I wanted to start, because I don't know if you know this, but you've seen that big, huge van of mine.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. So I was going to start van life. And I was going to start van life.
No.
Yeah. And so I was thinking, okay, well, maybe locking my hair would be the best, low maintenance. And so I was having like ideas already. And then after that, it was when I had met you officially without the 70s outfit.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, if you want to put that in. but yeah, so I had seen you and I was like, oh, that's summer. Okay. I was like, oh my God, her locks, they look so amazing.
Wait, this was at the 70s party?
No, this was after.
After?
It was at Trisha's house.
Okay.
We came over to visit.
Okay.
And
okay.
So... I had pulled that. Jazz aside, my girlfriend Jazz. I had pulled her aside and I was like, Jazz, did you see her hair? It's locked and it's beautiful. So I was like, oh my gosh, should I ask her like where she gets it done?
This is the first time I'm hearing this version.
I told you!
Of
events. No.
Okay, go ahead.
And so I was like, Jazz, should I like ask her if, you know, if where she's gotten it done? And she was like, yeah, you should ask. So I was like, okay, let me ask her. And so that's when we sat down, we were talking about stuff, and then I brought it up. I was like, Summer, where did you get your locks done? And you're like,
I did my own locks.
I was like, oh. So I freaked out even more. I was like, oh my God. We were like vibing really good.
Yeah,
I was like,
ooh. Yeah. Immediately.
Yeah. And so I was like, okay, I have to talk to her about this and how I've been wanting to lock my hair and get some questions in and some advice. And you gave the best advice, and she was great. It still is great. Like, she's like my guru. So that's basically kind of where I was like, yep, it's gonna happen. I'm talking to Summer, we're gonna get this done. And
the van life?
Yeah. There's like a bed set up in there and everything, but it's like not done yet. Now it's gonna turn into a camping van.
So you felt as though you wanted like just a minimalistic lifestyle, mm-hmm. and because of that, you mm-hmm. felt like, hey, locks would be something for me.
Because before that, I was natural, and so mm-hmm. I was like not disciplined with my hair at all. And so knowing that if I was gonna be in the van life, I'm gonna have to brush it out as often as I can, and it needs to be washed. And so, because if I don't wash it, I'll get the knots and it's gonna be all bad. And so thinking of if I had to do like truck stops and stuff like that, then like that's gonna be hard for me to do. So I figured the best low maintenance, and I was not trying to shave off my head or my hair. I was not trying to do that.
Got it.
So I was like, locks is probably the best deal for me.
Did you know anybody with locks prior to?
Mm-hmm. Nope, not one person. I didn't know one person with locks. So seeing your locks in person, it was like what? Oh yeah, Uncle Teddy in Geneva. Oh yeah, I forgot. I even asked Jazz, like, oh, can your Uncle Teddy do it? Like, this is before I met you. And I was like, can your Uncle Teddy do this? And he didn't seem like he was too confident probably to do my hair. So we kind of shied away from that. So I was just like, I was actually looking for other locticians around Austin. It was the most difficult thing to do. And then literally you just popped into my life and I was just like, okay.
I don't know. I kind of get where Uncle Teddy was coming from. Because it is a little like unnerving doing somebody else's hair, especially if you're like not licensed or trained or not really. Like, I know that I like doing hair. I like doing people's hair. I like doing my own. But still, like, I don't know. I felt like starting somebody's locks would be like, like really like intimidating.
Responsibility.
Yeah, like the weight of it was like. And then I was like, oh, Jen, are you sure? Like, is this something me? I mean, I don't know. I felt confident in what I could do, but I didn't know if I wanted to start her hair off and just wanting her to have a good foundation and then didn't want to mess up her hair in any way. So there was still a little apprehension, but I feel like I was still more excited than anything else.
She was more excited than me. I ain't lying on that. She was more excited than me. It was funny.
So when do you want to start, Jen?
Yep.
And it was like, when? Okay, let me go. Go ahead.
When did we start? It was in July. We started in July.
Yes. And I know why. I know when we started. I think something, did we push it back at least once or twice? I don't know.
Might have.
Okay.
I think so.
But it ended up being, she ended up starting her locks the same day I started my locks. So we have like a lockiversary, birthday, twinsy lock thing going on. So July 15th is when she started her locks of 2021.
Jeez.
So this year she's going to be 1 year. And I kind of know some of the answers to these questions, but I'm going to ask her anyway. What method did you start with and why?
Why are you asking me? I put on my notes that Summer's answering that. I don't know much. But we started with interlocking and twists.
Interlocking and twists. Yes. So we did 2-strand twists and then I interlocked the roots. And I only did that because, as you can see, like, Jen has really, like, a soft texture of hair. I know some people don't believe in hair typing, but if you were on that, if I were to look on that scale, she would be, like, a type 3. So she has really a soft grade of hair, and I just kind of felt like I wasn't going to do the coils because I kind of felt like it would just so I just did the twist and then interlocked the roots to kind of make sure that she had a strong anchor, a strong foundation. We maintain mostly with retwisting. I've interlocked once since the last time we did it. And I think, do you prefer, which one do you prefer?
So I wanted to talk to you about this.
Okay.
But I think with my texture, I think it has to be interlocked all the time. Like, I don't, really? Because it's like, it's understanding, oh, we got like weight to it now. Mm-hmm. So whenever I get weight to my hair, it tends to just kind of straighten out. And so now I see what's happening is it's just like not caring that it's being twisted.
Okay.
Doesn't matter what product you use, it just doesn't care.
Her hair has just like taken off, and I'll do a close up at some point, but her hair has really just. And this was also the young lady that I was telling you guys about that used the sea salt spray from Dolly Locks, and her hair just like locked within like the first month, 2 months. Like, her hair was like, I was like, what?
You talked to him how shocked you were, how fast it was.
The pictures. I mean, I think I put some of it in my, like, maybe 2 or 3 videos back where I talk about the Dolly Locks products and how, like, her hair just, I was like, Jen, it took my hair, like, 8 months to look like yours in what yours looked like in, like, a month or a month and a half. It was crazy. Yeah. Like, I really believe, like, her hair was some, like, meant to be locked.
Yeah.
So, like, wait, did you ever have, like, a perm or did you do relaxers?
So, from 6th grade till late 20s is when I was doing, or mid-20s, I was doing relaxer. But okay. It was off and on, so I can go like a few months without it, but majority of that time frame I was doing relaxers.
Okay.
And then I went natural in 2010.
So what made you decide to go natural?
I wanted to do it for me for once, because it seemed like I was always doing it for other people, because everyone liked, you know, straight hair, and it was just a thing, and I liked how it looked, but it was expensive, and it took so much time out of your day, and then I just was like, you know what, I don't care about what other people think anymore, and I'm just gonna do what I want, and it was, at that moment, like, kind of less maintenance, but more maintenance at the same time. But that's basically why I did my first big chop.
Of course. But what about your lock journey now? How are you feeling about it so far?
It's freeing. It's really freeing. And there's this time when your locks, you know, as one would know if they're in the lock journey already, is that it has this phase where it just looks a hot mess sometimes. And you get this, either you go one way or the other, and the one way, I'm kind of in the middle right now, but it's, you know, either you just don't care at all that, like, your hair looks the way it does, because you know what it's going to look like later on, and you just go on your way and just not care about what other people think and the opinions that you will get and hear, or you go the other way and you're just like, I can't do this and I can't handle this because this is not how my hair ever looks, blah, 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 blah. So, but right now I'm kind of just in the middle right now because majority of the time, like, my thing was like, I always had my hair done nice. I never left the house with like hair frizz or whatever. And so this is actually, it's not, I've grown up. So I've changed in that aspect. So it's not as hard on me, but I do still feel that way. Like, oh God, like, I don't know how to do my hair right now. And like, how do I style it? And yeah, it's still kind of hard, but I'm getting over it because I already know what's going to happen.
And she does really well with like head wrap styles. She's been making it work. Like, I congratulate her because it's not easy. The ugly, awkward, whatever stage, you know, that first year is the most like challenging. It will make or break your whole lock journey too, because either, as she said, you'll stay in it or you'll be like, you know what, I know what the end result will be, so I'm gonna just hang in there. And Jen's hanging in there. Okay, she is like not letting go. This is what she's about. She's committed and she's willing to go through the process, so I'm really proud of her. Like, she's been doing really, really well. How many locks do you currently have?
I have 106 right now.
Okay.
And
that hasn't changed. Now, how often do you wash? I know the answer to it.
Yeah.
But now I've been telling her that she can wash whenever she wants to, because her locks are kind of locked in there. I mean, she's still dealing with the typical frizz and everything else, but at this point, her locks are, you cannot even see the twist pattern in her hair anymore. Like, it's not even there. And is this 6 months yet? It is.
Yeah. It's 6 months this month.
Yeah, her two strand pattern is completely gone. I told her she can wash her hair anytime she wants, but she still, she waits until she comes to me and like, hey, it's time. It's about that time.
I'm too scared for it to just get together, even though I don't think at this point it would, but like with how it is now and not accepting a twist, I just feel like if I were to, I mean, if I'm careful, I probably could do it, but
the marrying of the roots and the whole pop in the locks thing, it's definitely an issue at the beginning because there's just so much loose hair and the locks trying to figure out exactly where they should go. So I understand her apprehension for not like wanting to wash right now. Like, I totally get it. Oh, if you started a new set of locks, what would you do differently?
I wouldn't do anything differently.
Really?
I really like how they are. Like, there's no...
And how many inches of hair did you start off with, would you say?
I wouldn't know. I know that my hair, at least after, when it was dry, I think it was up to here. But then I think it went to my collarbone.
I remember
at
the
least
day...
the back especially.
I think I have pictures on my phone too. I kept it. So I was like, I think I have,
that's
the
like
day, of, I'll make sure I'll insert pictures right here. Well, I will enjoy pictures. But on the day that she got her hair, like the first day that she got it installed, I really do think, yeah, it was hitting the shoulder. They look so skinny though.
Yeah, that's what I was like. I was thinking, okay, because my hair was damaged, so I knew that during this journey, I was like, okay, I don't even know if she's gonna have enough hair to actually lock.
I was worried,
and she ended up with this, and I was just really shocked, and she said 106, and I'm just like, I didn't understand that, because I thought it was me less. I thought it was me at like 70-something, and yeah. She was like, no.
She has a lot of hair. She has a lot. It's full, it has volume, and then the strands of itself are dense, so she has a good, like, grade of hair, density of hair, the texture. I mean, yeah, it's. I had no. I was nervous because I had never done like type 3 hair, especially with twists. I even thought her twists were gonna just unravel, but
I was like, no, they're not.
They did not.
I actually don't have anything that was weird so far that's been asked of my locks. But I will start with an interesting like experience that I've been having. When I first got the twist, when you first did my hair, I had started a new job, and you know, it looked all cleaned up and everything. So within like at least that first month, I got a lot of compliments from Black women saying, "Oh, I like your hair. It's really cute." And then once my hair started getting more natural looking, more frizzy, and more like, I didn't get no compliments, no one paid attention, no one like looked my way. And so I thought that was very interesting to experience, you know, seeing all those compliments and getting all that love, and then all of a sudden it just kind of like stops. And I was like, okay,
what
I see
she
what's
doing?
Going on. And then also it was kind of a shame because I know that there was a lot of women that had locked hair, and it's like, you guys know that I'm going through a journey. You guys could say something. And there has been a time where I wanted to say something to someone before, and I was too shy to say anything.
Wait, is it because they were like just staring at you?
No, nothing or... like that. It's just they're walking around, you know, around shopping, and just that encouragement. I wish that we had that more of that, because it's like, you obviously know I'm going through a journey of locking. If your hair is locked, like, let's just kind of show some love. And I'm gonna probably start doing that myself, like, oh, I love your hair, it looks beautiful, you know. Just start kind of communicating with each other, bringing that love, because we all need it, especially when you know I'm going through the journey to the beginning. I need the support.
Has anybody called your locks that didn't know you? Has anybody called your locks yet?
Mm-mm. It's still dreadlocks right now. No one's really saying locks. I think a lot of people are scared to comment or even bring it up. No, seriously. I think that people are like, I don't want to offend her. I don't know what's going on. Yeah, that's how I've been feeling. So I'm not feeling that type of way. It's just very interesting though.
I remember the first time somebody called my hair locks. I was so excited.
Yeah, I'm like,
yay! Does it look like a hot mess?
Yes.
Well, maybe it does, but they're still saying they're using the right term. Mm-hmm. And it was early in that first year. I was at like Target, and I think I had asked for help or something, and then they were like describing the person, like, "Hey, Black lady with locks, she wants." Okay. Black lady. But they said locks. Black lady with locks.
Okay.
Yep. Okay.
Yeah.
They ain't lying.
No, they ain't lying.
I'm black. I'm a lady. Yep. And they got the hair right. So I can't be mad. If your locks had their own personal motto, what would it be?
I think it would be, this is my time. This is my time.
Jen, that just made me cry.
My mom would always do my hair, so I'm mixed. My mom's white or part white, And so when she would do my hair, she actually did a pretty good job for a white lady. I was pretty impressed. She always had it real tight, and always had like, you know, I'd have like the one braid here, the one braid here, and it was cute. But she always did my hair, and it was always really good. So I, you know, from that transition from that hairstyle to then relaxing, I got so many compliments as a kid. And when I go from, you know, I'm now washing it out, and you know, now my hair is kind of semi-relaxed a little bit. People would ask, or like the kids, classmates would ask, oh, when are you gonna get your hair straight again? Like, I really like it. So you get that peer pressure over and over again. So I've always had that. And then, you know, when you're an adult, you know that like, this is what it is. Being black and having straight hair, that's just what it is. And you feel more attractive because that's what people are coming off. And so, with that, like, I'm just
over it.
I don't want to live my life on what people expect, or just, I just want it to be about me and care about how I look for me, and not be about anyone else and how they feel and their comfort also. Their comfort. I can tell my hair wasn't healthy, so I was just like, hey, I'm really doing this for other people, not necessarily for myself. And so I'm tired of it. And this is my time.
I love that. Yeah.
I don't care. Like, I'm doing what I want to do now. Mm-hmm. And it is more empowering, one, because I am, you know, I've grown up, I'm a lot older and wiser now. So it's more like a empowering in a sense of just, it literally is like a who cares.
I don't know. They kind of allow you to not take yourself so seriously.
Yes.
And at least that was my story about it. Like, it's just like, I don't want to take myself so seriously. Mm-hmm. I want to feel like I have to be in this box or look a certain way all the time. Yes. Like, it's okay to just be more laid back, yes, more casual. Like,
that is
it's
true.
It's not the end of the world. Serious. Yeah, it isn't.
Yeah.
And it's, yeah, as you said, yeah. Green.
Mm-hmm.
Green.
Yep.
Do you have any lock role models? If so, who?
You.
Oh, gosh.
And I only say that because, like, I mean, yeah, I saw Lauryn Hill and, like, when I grow up.
Thank you. Those are normal.
But, like, to actually be witness and to see person, it's, you're my role model. And, like I said, you guys know, like, she gives really great advice. And she's helped me, like, be, like, relaxed with it. Like, just chill out. You're okay. Everything's going to be fine.
Wash your hair, Jen. You can
Yeah,
you're going to be okay. You can do this, Jen.
See? So, like, how can I not have her as my role model?
Thank you, Jen. It's been a pleasure. Like, I've never started anybody's... I mean, I've put in people's hair extensions and all that stuff before, but I don't know. When she was... I was kind of nervous. I'm like, oh, do I really want her to wash her hair? That means that she's not going to come over this
Oh,
month.
My gosh.
Because I like, yeah, we talk, we laugh. Like, she comes over, she's with the kids. I mean, it's a big thing, you know? So... I've really enjoyed her being on this journey, not just for her sake, but for mine too. Like, I feel like it's almost like these are her little babies, and I get to see them like grow up.
Oh my!
Everything. Like, I don't know. I really like it. Yeah. I like doing her hair and like just seeing it evolve. Mm-hmm. And I know that in a couple of months, it's not going to look like this. And then even a year after that, it's not going to look like this. It's just like constantly, you know, changing. Mm-hmm. So her girlfriend's going to be getting her hair. And I know I will enjoy doing Jazz's hair.
Oh, geez.
Oh,
what'd
you say? Don't forget about me.
I'm going to enjoy doing Jazz. You guys are going to meet Jazz soon as well, because she's about to start her hair journey, her lock journey this year as well. So we're going to be doing a lock talk with her and interviewing her as well. But Jen has trailblazed, and she is about to enter her 1 year in a couple of months. And we're really looking forward to seeing how everything just comes together and how these locks just continue to flourish and grow. So So Jen, do you have any final thoughts or anything else you want to share with the people? This has been so much fun.
No, not bad. Yeah, it's pretty good. Thank God. I knew it was me fine. I was just like me being nervous. Anywho, I'd like to say, like, we all just got to remember it is just hair. Like, as many times, and it's hard. As many times that other people say it, yes, it's hard for us to actually, you know, comprehend that. But it literally is just hair. And I know in the Black community, it's sometimes more than just hair. And it can be tough, but like, do you, boo? Mm-hmm. And just, if you feel like whatever hairstyle it is, just do it. Just do it, try it out. If you don't like it, you don't like it. Right. It is what it is. But I just don't want any of us to live in regret.
Thank you again for joining us for our Lock Talk this month. Guys, stay tuned for more talks like this with other guests. I'm looking forward to sharing others' stories and their experiences. And I hope that you guys will tune in for the rest of the series. Until next time. Bye.